Hi, I'm Oscar van Deventer, and this is the Zigu Trees puzzle. As you can guess from the name, Zigu is a reference to the Ziggurat puzzle, and this is yet another variation to the concept. So, Zigu Trees is a set of rotating pieces on a hillside. So here you see one side of the hill and on the other, and from the top you can see that there are arrows, and things rotate. And as in the other Zigu puzzles, also here all the pieces have four states. The arrows can be pointing up, sideways, another sideways, and they can point down. And the fun thing about this Zigu puzzle is the way that things work. So the yellow piece can only rotate if the orange and red piece are pointing downward. So let's point them downward. And now the yellow one can rotate. And then we point these up again. So when they point in the same direction, then the next one can rotate. And let's move downward again. And here it can rotate. And now since orange and yellow are pointing downward together, we can make a rotation of the green piece. And then, of course, we can repeat the sequence. To get both the green and the yellow arrow up. And now the blue piece can rotate. So the puzzle is in its starting state when all the arrows are pointing uphill. And it's in its solved state when all the arrows are pointing downhill. And when all the arrows are pointing downhill, then you can slide the set of trees out of their frame. So again, you have this reward that you can take it apart when solved. And I'm really happy about this interaction. The three pieces here, by the way, they are mirror images of these here. So this is again a feature that we have seen in Brehm's original Ziggurat puzzle as well. And as usual, let me show you some of the prototypes that I've tried. So here I have a flat prototype just to get familiar with the concept, because what I wanted is to have pieces that don't only interact with the next one, but also with the next one in this triangle pattern. So, what you see here is a puzzle where, there are also rotations where things, it's a bit hard to demonstrate, but anyway, this puzzle was not binary, but only quadratic. That is, the number of moves is quadratic with the number of pieces that you have. So it was not binary. That's the reason why I didn't take this one. So I tried something else with the floor piece, where I made an error in the design. I tried to make a flat version without the hills. But there were other things that were not working. So I tried working on the hillside, but I got a little design aspect wrong with the pieces. Actually, there was no frame at the bottom, so that was the thing that needed to be added. So after quite a few prototypes, I got to the Zigu Trees. And my question to you is, well, you have seen many of my Ziggurat based puzzles, and my question is, how do you like this one compared to all the others? Thank you for watching.